Welcome back, guys. Here we'll try to understand. Let's say you have a static final variable which is not initialized. How do you achieve that? So as I said earlier, when it is variable is the non-static, you can do through constructor, but when it is a static, you can do through a static block, and you know that this static block will not depends on your object, and this will get executed only once per class. Unlike constructor, it can get executed multiple times based on how many times you are creating the object of your class, right? So whenever you have a static final variable which is not initialized, you can do through a static block, which you can see here. Here we have a variable which is not initialized. So first time when you write, you will get a compile time, but the moment you write a static block and you initialize that, the compile time error will go off, right? So this is about a static blank final variable and how you can do that. Now, what is final parameter? So is it possible to supply a final parameter? Yes, it is possible to supply a final parameter. So you can see that there is a method which takes final int n, right? So when it takes final int n, and I am trying to change this. Is this possible? Right? This is not possible. You will get a compile time error. That's what I was trying to tell you. So when you have a method with type is equal to final, and if the same variable you try to change it, you will try to reinitialize it, you will get a compile time. Whereas when you write like this, right, when you write like this, you should not have any issue. So let's see that through example. Look at here, there is a method called cube method, right, which does some calculations, and my variable method local variable is of type final. So when I will try to change this variable, it will tell you you cannot change that, right? The final variable n cannot be assigned, it must be blank or not using component assigned. So this is not possible, this you cannot change that. Whereas you can write like this, here you are not changing the reference, you are just doing some calculation and you are returning it. So you are not creating, you are not initializing with other variable, right? So you can write like this, but you cannot change your method final variable. You cannot change that. If you will do that, you will get a compile time, whereas you can return this because you are not storing this into a different reference. So same, let's say if I will do like this again, right, and if I'll write n is equal to this, also will give you compile time issue itself, because this final you are trying to reinitialize, so this will also give you compile time, whereas you can directly return that. So if you look at here, I'm creating the object of this class and I'm calling the method cube is equal to 5. So when I will call this, and let's say when I will print that SYSO control space bar, and if I'll run this, right, I'll get the right output, right? So you cannot change the final parameters. Final parameters, you cannot change that, but of course you can return like this. So people can ask you in the interview. And I think with this, we are done with the final concepts, final keyword in the Java. We have one more concepts. Can we declare constructor as the final? Is it possible to declare constructor as the final? No, we cannot. We cannot make constructor as the final. The moment you will do that, you will get a compile time error, right? So let's see that by making constructor as the final, what happens. Let me create a class called test 50, which has one constructor. Right, let me give the access is equal to public, so there is no error. I can create constructor as a public, or default, and let me write here final. The moment you'll write constructor, the final will get a compile time, because final cannot take anything else apart from public, protected and private are permitted, illegal modifier. So you know, when you write final for the constructor, it is understanding this final as a modifier, access modifier, which I spoke long back, and it is giving you the compile time. So you cannot make constructor as a final, right? Compiler will give you the compile time exceptions, because you are going to call this object from different classes. And let's say if your object is argumented object, let's say you have a parameterized constructor, you are going to supply a lot of data, you are going to change your object. If you make object as a final, if you make constructor as a final, you cannot use from the other classes and you cannot change the data. So that is the reason you cannot do that. I think you have seen that when I made class as the final, you cannot inherit, right? You will get a compile time, because final class you cannot inherit. Why you cannot? Because you cannot change the method implementations what you have in the final class. So that is the reason we don't have privilege to do that. So with this, we are done with the final, and I think hope I covered all the points what final keyword in Java we have. In next video I will start with some new concepts. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this.